There have been quite the plethora of Plaid Model S sightings, and for the record, when I say Plaid Model S, I'm not necessarily referring to the Tri-Motor variant, I'm just referring to the 2021 Model S. It's just Plaid Model S rolls off the tongue a lot easier than 2021 every single time, so not all of these could be the Tri-Motor variant. I'm just trying to save you guys some time that I can now eat up by explaining why I explained it that way. Anyway, since last week where I first posted that video of the first Model S refresh spot in the wild at a Tesla service center, there have been quite a couple more posted around the Fremont area, which have actually confirmed that yes, Elon was telling the truth when he said that the Model S is in production. We even saw a short little video clip of what appears to be a factory worker filming the inside of the Model S, and it even has the factory mode text on the display, which is something that we only see with internal footage, so I'm pretty convinced this is real. I don't think someone would go through all of the work to post this video and then actually take it down later if it was fake. So I'm pretty confident this is legit, and once again showing us clips on the inside of the car with a full complete steering wheel. Except I've got some good news for you since the last video we posted. For one, the plastic Dixie cup that goes over the emergency stop button doesn't appear to be a standard thing, okay? So no Dixie cup on the rest of these sightings, unfortunately. I'm sorry. I know some of you were big fans of the Dixie cup, some of us weren't, but on the rest of these models it appears that that is gone, and also the little white labels beneath the phone chargers are not present on these other sightings. And also, some people were very concerned when they saw the complete full steering wheel on that Plaid Model S prototype because it had a piano black texture around the scroll wheels, which of course looked very, very weird for fingerprints, not a very clean design for day-to-day driving, whereas these new pictures that have been revealed probably are a lot closer to the production model, and they have more of a matte finish that is closer to the render we saw on Tesla's official website. One guy named Nick spotted the new Model S saying that it looks quite a bit wider in person and it was driving around on the freeway. And as you can see in the pictures, there's still a complete full steering wheel. And then, bizarrely enough, another guy named Nick also spotted the Plaid Model S. Not the same Nick, though. Is it a coincidence that only guys named Nick are spotting the Plaid Model S? I think, yeah. Probably. Most likely just happened to work out that way. It's a very common name, actually. But once again, on the inside, we can see that this is clearly not a complete model. There's a lot of parts missing, and they're probably doing road testing with this. But yeah, at least in the factory footage and all of the sightings we've seen so far, full steering wheel appears to be the standard across the board, which has me thinking that that full steering wheel we saw last week was not necessarily a one-off. Maybe the fact that it had the little piano black texture for some reason, maybe that was a one-off. But so far, with all of these sightings, we have not seen this steering yoke on any of them. We haven't seen them in the factory, we haven't seen them road testing. In fact, outside of the renders on Tesla's website, we really haven't seen the yoke anywhere, which makes me think, given regulators in the United States haven't really been very clear on whether or not the yoke is illegal or legal, although if you check the YouTube comments section, people seem to be very, very well versed on the subject. Depending on who you ask, it is completely and totally legal, or it is completely illegal and dangerous, and there's no real in between. The fact is, Tesla appears to not be manufacturing it right now, and while a service center employee did state last week that it would be an optional thing, the one thing that I think is far more controversial for more people is the fact that all of these production models and all of these prototypes that have been cited, none of them have gear stocks, which I think almost divides more people than the yoke actually does, because there's a lot of people still rightfully very concerned at the idea of the car trying to guess which direction you want the car to go. And even though there's supposed to be a touchscreen override feature where you can tap the display and say, actually go forward, actually go backward, a lot of people are just nervous about not having a physical override. And that appears to be actually coming to market because none of these prototypes have been seen with gear stocks. One footage clip we saw was from a very reliable leaker, Tesla, which has a decent track record. But yeah, they tweeted out a video of the Plaid Model S doing winter testing. And in that video, you could actually see the top of the steering wheel on the inside. So once again, I have to really, really wonder what Tesla is thinking internally. I mean, Elon Musk on the latest Joe Rogan podcast talked about how the yoke is awesome and it's fun to drive with, and Joe was kind of bickering with him on that, saying, you know, I like to drive like this, a lot of people like driving like this, and Elon's response was kind of just, eh, car's gonna drive you most of the time anyway, so big whoop. Who knows, maybe that means that you only get the yoke if you buy full self-driving, and then maybe if you don't order full self-driving, you just get a normal steering wheel. Does that logic make sense to you guys? I don't know, but it seems that Elon is on board with the yoke idea, saying he likes it, and I'm guessing Franz likes it too, given the Cybertruck had a yoke, the Roadster had a yoke. Some division at Tesla seems to be very much in favor of going forward with yokes on their high-performance vehicles, but what production is seeing and what's actually coming out of the factory and what we're locating on city streets these days all seem to be going forward with the full steering wheel idea. So options are good at the end of the day. If you want to have a full steering wheel, I am all in favor of you guys getting what you want. But I'm still at the end of the day wondering, for those of us who are actually pumped about the yoke, or some of us who want to really try this design, how are those people going to make sure that when they order a new Model S or X, they get notified that, hey, this one's going to have a yoke or this one's not going to have a yoke? Because there was actually a hidden image in Tesla's website that showed the full steering wheel. It's hidden within the code, so you can't really see it publicly, but people pulled it out of the site, and it definitely lines up and looks exactly like all of the sightings we've been locating. So why not just show that on the website, right? Like, if down the road later you were gonna offer the yoke as an aftermarket add-on, like, you can schedule a service appointment and someone will come out and swap out the steering wheel with a yoke, why not bring that up down the line? And why still show the yoke on the website still to this day if that's not really what people are actually going to be getting once they get their hands on the car? To me, this isn't like a little fine detail. You know, sometimes the Model Y got the updated center console, but the website hadn't quite reflected that yet. There's little details like that where I'm like, okay, the render on the site might not be completely accurate with what actually comes out, but steering wheel versus yoke is a drastic impact on the drivability of the car. All of it comes down to personal preference, of course, but some people just straight up hate it, and some people I've seen straight up love it. So making sure people know exactly what they're ordering and they get what they asked for in the first place, I would say is pretty important. But if I had to guess based on all the sightings we're seeing so far, I'm pretty confident that the full steering wheel is going to be standard on both the Model S and the X when they come out. And maybe down the line, Tesla will have some type of yoke option that you can upgrade via service appointment, or maybe even upgrade yourself. I wouldn't be against making some kind of easy detachable latch that would let you pop off the wheel and put something else on if you want. But Tesla's usually not that crazy about letting users and drivers adjust and customize the vehicle that much, so probably not going to happen. But I will just give you guys a fair warning to those of you thinking about ordering an S and X: most likely gonna come with the steering wheel, but on top of that, it most likely isn't gonna come with gear stocks. That sounds like something they're sticking true to their guns with, and they have the little capacitive buttons on the wheel that you're gonna use for signaling and autopilot. And like I talked about before, now that they have a dedicated button for the microphone, that means that holding down the right scroll wheel doesn't really have a purpose anymore to activate the microphone. So potentially they might make that your backup, like if you want to activate reverse or forward in a situation where the car is guessing incorrectly, then maybe you'll just be able to hold down that scroll wheel and it'll adjust for you. So that could be your manual override. What do you guys think Tesla is planning here? Why do you think so many of the models have the full wheel? Why did they bake that into the website? And when do you think we're actually going to see some Teslas with yokes equipped? Feel free to let me know. Thank you all for watching. Hope you have an excellent rest of your day. Take care.